first.
2 minutes of television wow that makes you buy now.
But I'm still not done.
Direct response ads are a multi-billion dollar industry.
Billy Mays here for OxyClean.
Billy Mays.
Hi, Billy Mays here.
And Anthony Sullivan.
Anthony Sullivan here.
Our Pitchmen.
You're making too much money. Mr. Lower your rate.
Two guys.
But wait, there's more!
With the A-game and national fame.
Best Pitchmen.
These two veteran pitch pros have mastered the art of turning good ideas into must-have products. Now, they're putting their egos aside and their heads together.
You don't want to talk to me?
I see you, but I don't hear you. It's great.
They're going to help everyday people with great ideas go from rags to riches.
This is a home run.
And maybe turn someone's million-dollar dream into a reality.
Your dreams come true.
But you have to watch now.
Here's how to order.
On this episode of Pitchmen.
Yeah. Watch that way.
90 pounds, but it feels like 20.
An inventor creates the ultimate load-carrying device.
Came up with ideas all my life. Some are a little wacky, and once in a while you come up with a good one. And this is a big one.
And later, can Billy help an inventor with a tragic past score his next big hit?
Billy Mays here with the awesome auger.
It's very exciting. You know, you take something from a drawing board to this. It's like American dream come true, really.
I'm the inventor of Jacques, which is Hungarian for sack.
It all starts with a pitch. Someone has an idea and wants to sell it to the world.
This is not an ordinary sack. Carry it anywhere, on your side or your shoulder. And after you take your stuff out of it, it will work as a stylish hat. One size fits all.
Sometimes these inventions are designed to make life easier.
This is the wrist list. What it is a reusable magnetic list. Fasten it to my wrist. Now my hands are free for shopping. When I come home, take it off, put it back on the fridge, and wipe off my list.
Sometimes they're just for fun.
Marco Polo's a great game. We all have to play it in the pool. One big problem with it, kids cheat. The Marco Polo goggles will stop them from cheating. Huh, Marco?
And sometimes they're aimed at very specific problems.
This is a specimen cup holder. It folds over the porcelain of the toilet. You put the lid down on top of the plastic, which holds it down in place.
Which of these inventions have caught the interest of Billy and Sully? Actually, none of them.
The Kazi cup is the ultimate cup holder.
How big it is?
Your car, your truck, your boat, your RV.
What's wrong with a normal cup holder?
Billy and Sully are pre-screening submission tapes from dozens of inventors in preparation for a scouting trip they're taking to the Invent Bay Convention in Las Vegas.
I already don't like this guy. TV silencer, he's putting us out of business.
Yep, the TV silencer. Now she can hear the phone.
If this is the current state of inventions, me and you are going to be going bankrupt, buddy.
We're miners, remember. We sift through.
Sift through. Sifting. Look at
TV silencer.
Next.
At Invent Bay, they'll be able to sift through hundreds of new inventions in a very short period of time.
It is a new system that doesn't require laces to be tied.
My name's George Boyd, and I invented this power bike.
I'm Gary Hartz, the inventor of sprinkle lights.
Billy and I have come to Invent Bay today. I'm going to hopefully find one invention. To be honest, I'll be happy if I can walk out of here with one. If I get two, it'll be a bonanza. If I get three, it'll be absolutely worth the trip.
After a quick tour around the convention, Billy and Sully settle into their booth, where inventors from all over the world have come to pitch their ideas to the pitch pros.
I love dealing with inventors because it's the heartbeat of what I do. In fact, it's like sifting through and finding that diamond in the rough.
Billy and I are looking for that mass market item that solves a common problem, that's easily demonstrable, that you get in 5 seconds, that sells at the right price, that we can put on the shelf in every single retailer across the country and get on every single TV station.
This is the flatulence deodorizer.
Flatulence?
Yes, intestinal gas for some. It is an activated charcoal cloth pad that is worn inside the underwear next to the buttocks.
I needed that for him this morning.
Oh, well,
that was huge.
We'll leave you one.
Hold on.
Has this been used or is this a new one?
It's a brand new one. Pretty sure. So, yeah.
So if you have those SBDs, silent but deadly.
Who denies it?
This covers it, Billy.
Wow. I don't think it falls into my product profile. I don't know about him. We call Stinky Sully.
Yep.
Thanks for your time.
Oh, sure. Thank you guys for the opportunity. Did you want to keep one?
Yeah. We need that. All right. Who's next?
Some inventions just don't demo well on TV.
Bill Gates earlier this year said the days of the keyboard are coming to an end.
So in other words, that would replace my keyboard.
Yeah. The entire keyboard. Yeah. And then, show you. It's A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. And then a shift, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, another shift, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. And space, backspace, enter, period, question mark, exclamation, tail, comma, apostrophe.
Sometimes Billy and Sully can't even figure out what the invention is designed to do, which isn't a good sign.
Thanks for coming up.
All right, what do we got next?
After a few non-starters, Billy and Sully are hoping to see something they can move forward with.
This product right here, the portable at mat, it's made from plastic.
How heavy is it?
This is a prototype.
Let me feel it. Okay, you can make that a little lighter, I understand.
12 pounds. It opens up into a mat. One of the claims to my patent is the foot inserts.
The word portable, this is probably the biggest ab mat I've seen. The ab mat, that guy needs to stop inventing. He's basically taken something and overcomplicated it. I admire his passion, but it's not selling on my time.
Halfway through their day, Billy and Sully meet the inventors of the Fozlock, which won Best New Invention of the show.
This is a faucet locking device.
And just locks on.
That's it.
The people who take vacations and they leave their home and they want to be able to come back and not have to shut the water off permanently, so they just want to cover it up.
It's a good idea. It's well engineered. Yeah. There's only one issue we have from what we do, and I know you've seen Billy on TV probably a thousand times, is it's prevention. To do a TV commercial for something like this, I'm just giving you the rundown, but still not to say you don't sell a couple million units in the home improvement store. Just because we knock you down on one invention doesn't mean you're a terrible inventor. It just means it's probably not right for television. Next! How you doing, guys?
How are you?
What do you got?
It's a robotic snow shovel, just like the automatic.
The ice shovel?
Yes.
So how does it work?
We had to first mark the perimeter with the aluminum tape, which is available in the market.
So like the invisible dog fence, you
kind
set
of like
the perimeter of your driveway?
Yes, in the driveway.
I think the ice shovel's a good name. I don't know if it's for me and Billy on TV. Thank you very much.
Thank you. A lot of people come to Vegas to gamble. These people came here to gamble with their inventions, with their dreams on the line. It's one thing to gamble with money, but to gamble with their dreams is saying something.
This is a prototype made of an igloo box.
So this is a regular cooler, right?
Just a regular old cooler. And then you shut it, and then you can lock it. See, now it's locked.
How do you lock it?
It's a pod. It's developed with a pod.
Right. If somebody wanted to get into this cooler, they couldn't, right? But they could take the cooler.
For the next several hours, Billy and Sully take scores of pitches with no success. After a 14-hour pitch-a-thon, Billy and Sully are about to call it a day when one last inventor, Ron Komoroski, hunts them down.
This is granite.
Now you got my attention.
And it used to hurt your back, right?
Yeah.
How much that weigh?
90 pounds, but it feels like 20.
See, this one would really hurt your back, right?
How'd you come up with it?
I had a herniated disc for many years, so I studied about the back. And I realized if you pick up an object, it can be up to 20 times the amount of pressure in your lower vertebrae. So what this does is put the load, sit up straight for a minute, directly on top of your shoulders. Then we have this hook attachment. Just slip them in.
I like that.
You got a whole motorcycle picked up here.
Yes.
You can.
You pick that up.
Yep. And we're gonna.
How much does the motorcycle weigh?
Maybe about 300, but I'd like to put one on you and you try it for yourself.
Oh, I'm happy to try it.
Grab the shoulder pads. Put it over your head.
Is that on?
Come on out for a second. That's it.
My hands are completely relaxed. Almost.
Now, how about trying to feel now?
Look, one finger. Look.
No, I get it. I get it. I get it.
Jeez.
Okay.
Here go the other ribs.
You pushing down?
Yeah.
Any problems?
No, it feels like nothing.
How about pulling? Give us.
You want me to pull?
Feel the pulling power?
Yeah.
It's triple.
Oh, how does this thing with this work? How does that work?
Okay.
Do we need the hooks or no?
Try them.
So if I hook these around the handle?
Yeah, use the hooks.
So hook them around here?
Mm-hmm. You can take your hands off.
Look, Billy.
No hands. We could give him a little ride. My name is Ron Komorowski. I'm an inventor, and I'm here showing my invention. I'm from Raritan, New Jersey. I always came up with ideas all my life. I guess since I'm a little kid, a guy like me, you know, so I'm a little wacky, and once in a while you come up with a good one, and this is a big one.
Oh, yeah. How you doing?
Coming up. Will Ron's handy straps be able to carry the infomercial load?
I don't know, but you're getting that down to $19.99.
No, and I don't want it there.
And later, out of disaster comes an inventor's flash of genius.
And unfortunately, I crashed my airplane upon landing.
After taking hundreds of pitches from passionate inventors, Billy and Sully have found only one invention they're interested in. Ron Komorowski's handy straps, a harness designed to turn ordinary people into supermen.
Everybody comes up with these ideas if they knew what to do with them. Well, maybe we'd all be multimillionaires, but it's about the pursuit. It's your idea. You have the passion. As you can see, I have great passion for what I'm doing. Nobody's gonna carry my invention like I can.
Proportional distribution of weight is the secret to the handy straps. By evenly transferring the weight of an object from the arms and the hands to the large muscles of the upper body, people wearing the system should be able to carry significantly more weight with no risk of back injury.
What are you selling for now?
60.
I'm just gonna stop you right there. $60 is not a magic number.
This,
especially in the 2-minute product. I understand that. Tough economy, 2-minute form that we run in, it's not a magic number.
Yeah, but you can bring the cost down a little bit. We can get it to where it needs to be.
I don't know, but you're getting that down to $19.99.
No, and I don't want it there. There's a lot of work and engineering just in these pads.
I can feel
to make sure.
I felt the product. And the thing is, I don't want to just sell a couple hundred thousand, 100,000. I want to sell millions. I don't want to even touch it if I can't sell millions. And I think you would appreciate that passion for me.
Here's what we should do. I'd like to do, if you don't mind. I'd like to get the product.
I'd like to take one
with me, if you don't mind. I want to get the website, go look at it, and maybe it's a 30-minute. He says he'd get bored in 30 minutes. It could be. If it's a 30-minute, you can go $60 all day long. If it's a 2-minute, we got a problem with the price, which means we have to figure a way to make it for less.
When they call me back, I'm sure they're gonna have some constructive information for me one way or another. I hope that we can work together with something. If not this product, I have many more. This is not the first one, this is not the last one. I have a whole bucket full of ideas, and hopefully we can build some kind of relationship.
After an exhaustive day of meeting with inventors, the Pitch Pros head back to Tampa with just one invention, and it's only a maybe. The next day, Billy's on his way to shoot a spot for one of his biggest hits, the Awesome Auger, which is exactly the kind of mass market product the guys have been looking for.
Today's a big day for the Awesome Auger shoot.
Today, Billy will update the Awesome Auger commercial, hoping to build on the success of his friend Tom Atasco's invention.
The world's most efficient and powerful yard tool you'll ever use. Just attach it to any size drill. Cool.
The awesome auger is the brainchild of a longtime friend of Billy's.
My name is Thomas Matosko, and I'm the inventor of the awesome auger. I first met Billy in the 70s, and he was a young kid at a flea market in Rogers, Ohio. He hasn't changed a bit. He's the same kid, fun-loving, energetic, as he was back then.
Looking forward to seeing my buddy Tommy. It's been a while. Here's a guy that was one of the best pitchmen there was.
When I was growing up, my father was a pitchman. We worked at the flea markets, the county fairs, the state fairs. The first slicer I ever sold, I was about 12 years old. I had a knack for it. I guess I had a talent for it. And I made a decent living doing it.
Thomas enjoyed the life of being a successful pitchman and used his newfound wealth to buy a plane.
I started flying from show to show whenever it was possible. And I flew for 20 years. And in 1996, I was flying to Ohio to help my father at a county fair. And unfortunately, I crashed my airplane upon landing.
Tom's injuries were nearly fatal. When he awoke, he had to face a new life as a double amputee.
I was in an induced coma for months, and people would tell me when I would come in and out of consciousness that I had lost my legs, and I didn't realize it for about 6 months. Then I just was, like most people would be, depressed, angry, didn't know how I was going to survive. I had neuropathy. This one hand still doesn't work after all this time. I had nerve damage. My whole body was paralyzed from the neck down. You couldn't touch me anywhere without me screaming in tremendous agony. Physical therapy was difficult. There were days I didn't want to go. My youngest brother was visiting, and I did not want to go to therapy that day. And he said, well, let's just call the nursing home now, because that's where you're going. And that was a wake-up call for me. And I realized that no one could do this for me. I have to do this for myself.
After a long and painful recovery, Tom realized his pitching days were over. And that's when inspiration struck.
I was laying on the floor at my father's house in Youngstown, Ohio, exercising after my last surgery, when my dad's next door neighbor was digging in his garden. And he was about 75 years old, on his hands and knees. And I just had been looking through the bag that my father had brought back from the airplane crash. And in that bag, there was a set of tie downs, which screw into the ground with a hook on it, and you could tie your airplane down. I put just something clicked in my head. And I said, you know what, you could put that on a drill to dig holes for planting flowers. That's how I came up with the awesome auger.
All set, awesome auger day. It's an emotional day for me because I haven't seen Tommy in a while and been honored to work side by side with him when he was able to walk. Was one of the best pitchmen around. And his accident has only made him stronger, and he's an example for us, and it's just gonna be a great day.
Coming up, the awesome auger shoot gets underway.
Let's go! Dude, the awesome auger is totally awesome!
Dude.
And later, can the handy strap stand up to the big test?
Take Billy up!
After surviving a harrowing plane crash, former pitchman Tommy Matosko invented one of the most successful products in direct response history, the awesome auger.
I went from what people would consider one of the best knife demonstrators in the country to where I can't hold the knife in my hand anymore. So I'm now adapting to going from being a pitchman that demonstrated products to inventing products to sell to pitchmen.
For today's shoot, Billy is updating an already successful campaign for the awesome auger. Last year, it was one of the top earners in the direct response industry.
Let's go.
Three, two.
It's fast, it's easy, It takes the hard work out of yard work. Again?
It takes the hard work out of yard work.
So keep going.
Yeah.
It takes the hard
Billy work is out re-teaming with Scott Opfer, who directed the first awesome auger spot.
Job done. Here we go. 3, 2.
It's fat. Sorry.
Oh, yeah. Nice effort. What is that? Lunch? Is that the ShamWow? Oh, sorry.
Scott knows nothing gets under Billy's skin quite like the mention of rival pitchman Vince and his ShamWow.
Who's the ShamWow guy? He's all over the place. Nice.
He's a one-hit wonder. I had Zorbies for a year, and he knocked me off.
ShamWow by a mile.
Get out of here, ShamWow by a mile.
You know what I think he needs? Maybe you should use a ShamWow.
Now you really. You know what? No, don't talk about that. No.
You get a ShamPow. I don't care if you're a mayor or state legislator. I'll give you a noogie, then a ShamPow.
Hey, can we get a ShamWow on the set, please?
You gotta just do that, huh? Is that incentive or something?
Got a little something to pump you up.
It'll pump me up.
I can light the fire a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, make the blood boil.
How about make the blood?
Yeah. Nobody manages Billy. You know, he's just a great guy. You know, it makes it fun.
Dude, the awesome auger is totally awesome. Righteous.
Dude,
where's my auger?
So how you doing?
I'm not any thinner. I'm not any better looking. So.
Well,
look, my hair's not getting any longer.
I used to be taller and better looking too, so we're both in the same boat.
Yeah. How's that?
When I wanted to manufacture this auger, I had my wife, who's an architect, make some drawings, and we sent the drawings over. And trial and error, they'd send samples over, we'd reject them, they'd send different ones, we'd accept them. And finally, we got a model that we thought could work.
The Awesome Auger is a smaller version of a traditional auger, specially designed to work with any power drill. Once powered up, its rotating sharp blades and spiral design help it break through hard, rocky earthen clay.
Like my father always said, there's enough good stuff to sell that you don't have to sell junk. Well, this is a nice product. I'm very proud of it.
Tom has been hard at work for years on a slew of new inventions. If Billy and the team continue to make the awesome auger a success, Tom will have the money he needs to develop those ideas.
The awesome auger is number one because it gets the job done.
Good.
Our stand-up's done quick. Not like Sully, you know, he likes to, you know, it's dramatic, draws it all out. Wolf's a witness here. You know, it's no full day. I get here at 10, I'll be done by 2. We're lucky. That's with lunch. It's a powerful tiller. I'm bringing it up.
It's very exciting. You know, you take something from a drawing board to this. It's a wonderful experience. It's like American dream come true, really.
Good to see you, brother.
Glad you had a minute.
I do. Good to see you, man.
Good, you got that.
To be the spokesman for Tom's product, we go way back. His family. I used to go to the flea markets and back in Ohio, and you know, I'm from Pittsburgh and Tom's from that area.
Let me give you one of these. I'm making this now. And
don't stop, Tom, huh? Nothing stops.
Well, I got plenty of free time. Remember the old Pope Peel?
The decorator?
Yeah, well, I changed a little bit of it, made sure my patent lawyer said I could do what I did.
Oh, I used to do that.
Got a good peeler.
People like Tom don't come around a lot in his life, and I'm fortunate to be his friend. And I'm fortunate to be able to work with him. I really am.
This is the first time in 20 years that I can honestly say lunch and rap at the same time.
You're the man.
Way to go, brother.
Move on.
Coming up, the crew at Sullivan Productions give Ron Komorowski's handy straps the stress test.
I mean, now what?
And later, a side of Billy that's rarely seen.
I was an absent father, but I was always took care of them, and I had to travel.
Billy has completed a new awesome auger spot for his old friend Tom Otosko. If it continues to be a DirecTV hit, Tom will have the money he needs to develop his next invention and bring it to market. Now, Billy and Sully turn their attention to finding the next big idea, and they're hoping that Ron Komorowski's handy straps will be just the ticket.
I think with my sports background, and you always want to play in the game, you always want to score that touchdown, you always want to hit that one over the fence, it's something inside, it's a drive from inside. My big thing is contribution. I contribute something to society, something to the world. And that payback, that feeling, is just irreplaceable that money can't buy.
You'll like this. It's double your lifting power.
Here, remember, I pay attention.
You do?
Put this on. Lift up. Lift your head.
Today, the guys have enlisted the help of their crew to test the handy straps and see if it has what it takes to go all the way.
Does it feel lighter?
Yes, no. What cap was
it? It looks like my hand.
Is this something you'd use every day?
No, I don't think so. But, you know, this isn't obvious.
Is it lighter?
I can pick this up.
Yeah, but is it light?
It's a little crate of
cord. Why don't we put it on Carla?
Let's do it on her, because at least she was...
But hold on,
no,
did it make it lighter?
Try
to make it lighter.
Did you try it? Like...
Not really, dude. It's a.
All right, well, let's
what do you mean, dude? Don't do me.
Don't do
me. Come on.
Well, it's a course.
Be honest.
I mean, that up all the day. No, it didn't.
It made it lighter?
No.
Load it up.
I think I've seen one of these things hanging from a ceiling once.
Whoa.
Hello. How about this?
You look good in
the
it.
Wingspan? Yeah. Yeah. Feel good in it.
You look like Sigourney Weaver in Aliens.
I did have to lift it here. It's too long.
Make it lighter?
Look, you can give me a high five while you're holding something.
Put your hands free.
This is heavy.
Pick up this without it first. That's heavy, right?
Yeah. That's a lot easier.
That is.
Yeah, because you lift them with your back.
Yeah, watch your tooth. You can lift the ladder and chip your tooth all in one simple motion.
Someone sit here. Hold on, just make sure the ladder doesn't collapse.
Hey. Get up, Pete. Get up, Pete. Get up, Pete.
Wait a minute, one person at a time.
Billy.
I'll support this.
Make sure that doesn't fall off.
When I say pick Billy up, pick Billy up. Pick Billy up!
Use your back.
I can't
make it. That one's actually a large.
That's a large. Can you imagine if you didn't have the mobility of your back or your arms? If you were like...
Would that fit around the pole at your house?
Your long arms.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
So he's putting it backwards, too. That's the way you want to do it.
Yeah, but, I mean, well, now it's, what?
No. Am I lighter?
No, it's heavy, buddy.
But no.
I mean, I can lift it, but now what do I do?
Seriously?
Go ahead.
It's weird.
Hernia?
It's just awkward the way you have to
just
hold.
Just get on it.
It's a bend down too far.
There.
Like,
you have to pick it up. Like, well, just pick it up like that.
Yeah.
I mean, now here's the deal. If you put it up there,
up there.
Then you hook it on. Hook that side on. Okay, now
you're hooked. I mean.
Do they want to do a 30-minute or a 2-minute?
No, I don't know.
It's too expensive for 2 minutes.
It's very expensive. The thing is, if you had, you know, the disability of your arms. I mean, you couldn't use your hands.
How big of the market is that?
Yeah, I know that it's not a big market. I mean,
right.
I know, but
that's
it does. He actually is trying to help people.
Yeah,
He wants to go mainstream with a not mainstream.
It's made in the U.S. I mean, the guy's
very high quality.
To it, but.
Now I want one.
The focus group wasn't a big hit with the crew, and the price point is a major issue.
The $60 has been actually on everybody's mind here. It's just way too high for anybody to comprehend.
When Billy and Sully produce a 2-minute spot, they deal exclusively in products priced at $19.99 or less. To get more than that, they would need to produce a half-hour infomercial, like they did with inventor Frederick Siama's dual saw, which sold for well over $100. But that production had several wow demos, including cutting through a safe, Frederick cutting himself out of a steel box, and cutting a car in half. Handy straps might not demonstrate as well.
I like to give a little checklist. One, does it have the wow factor?
It has the strength to pull HMS Bounty across ocean waters.
Two, does it have mass appeal?
One scoop in every load of laundry.
Three, is it demonstrable? 4, does it solve a problem? 5, does it give one instant gratification?
Handy straps is a tough one because it actually does meet a lot of our requirements. It is new and unique. It does demonstrate. You know, we need something right now. I'd like to shoot this, but the other side of me says don't shoot it. So I think Billy and I are both really, really on the fence with this one.
Coming up, the verdict is in on the handy straps.
Initially, right off the bat, you know, we both like the product.
And later, in a surprise move, Billy and Sully pitch a solution to a problem that's close to their hearts. Handy Straps inventor Ron Komorowski anxiously awaits Billy and Sully's decision as to whether they will take on the Handy Straps or not.
Hey, Ron?
Ron?
Yes.
It's Anthony Sullivan and Billy Mays.
How you doing?
Struggling like everybody else. I think, you know, toilet paper and bombs are selling these days. Nothing else. You know, it's just too tough.
Well, now we just want to give you a call about Handy Straps.
You made a good product. You engineered it well. Initially, right off the bat, you know, we both liked the product.
Yeah.
Right now, with the economy the way it is, I mean, you know, your price is really a tough price to go for.
To reach into your pocket and fork over $60 for something that you don't need and you're not going to use it every single day.
Right.
In this economy, it's going to be tough, and there's no doubt in my mind.
You know what? At this point in time, you know, I have to say, Ron, that we're going to pass on this product.
What's your number? What's your numbers? If you said, you know, get it, see if I can get it down to $39.95.
It's not enough, Ron.
You wanted to keep it at 60, and now you want to change it at the last minute, and this is what I'm afraid of.
There's going to be other opportunities, Ron, and, you know, I wish you all the best, but, you know, I think you're going to do fine.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thanks, Ron.
Thanks a lot, guys.
All right. Take care. Bye-bye.
Appreciate it. The handy straps can wait for right now, but right now we need to get on to bigger and better things that's better for our economy, solve some better problems.
Even though the guys are passing on his handy straps, Ron isn't giving up. He believes in his invention and will continue to pursue his dream.
You don't always get everything together perfect the first time. I hope that I can continue to work with these guys on some kind of product. If it's not this, I'll go back to the garage and I'll go get another one and I'll be back.
Having closed the book on the handy straps, Billy and Sully are still empty-handed. Their search will continue. But in the meantime, they're shooting a new spot for one of their biggest hits, and today, it's a family affair.
Arwen, I don't think you ever met my mother.
Hi, nice to see you.
Today, we're shooting a commercial that's a little bit different to normal. It's for a company called ICANN, and they're a health insurance provider. And Billy is super, super passionate about it because of the amount of uninsured people in this country. So he's so into this. He's actually got his whole family here. His mom is even on set. And it's kind of nice to see them all together. And his little girl is just the cutest little thing on the planet.
Yeah, you could go see me.
Who's the craziest, Big Billy, Daddy, or Little Billy?
Little Billy.
Little Billy's the most crazy, huh?
You're crazy.
Billy's 24-year-old son from his first wife works side by side with his father as a production assistant. However, it wasn't always the case.
I was an absent father, but I was always took care of them, and I had to travel. I ran the road of a pitchman for a long time, and it was a tough way to make an easy living. And you age 10 years in 5, and you pay your dues.
Remember being, feeling so bad on a holiday for him, but he had to work. And it's the only way he could afford to take care of Billy and his mother, you know, the way he wanted to. He gave Billy and his mother a good life by travel on the road. He gave up something to make something.
Age of 40, I became
I got on television, so my life started after 40.
Billy is remarried and has started a second family with his new wife.
I'm grateful for everything that I have. I'm thankful for everything I have. I thank the Lord every day for what I have, and I just want to pass it on. I want to leave a legacy, a good legacy.
I love you, Mom. I love you too, sweetheart. You're my boy.
Ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
Okay.
Born ready.
Changing.
The new Billy Mays.
The new Billy Mays. I don't even want to touch you.
Don't touch me. You know, I'm not a suit and tie guy, but still got the blue shirt, got the navy blue blazer. You know, I feel good.
Ladies and gentlemen, the executive Billy Mays.
The main 1 minute is over there, all over there.
Why? I want everything on green screen, and then I want the key scenes over here. You just be talent, and I'll produce today, all right?
Good, I've already produced this show in my head, and I've already written
it. I know, it's nice. So, it's nice to see you do that. It's thinking of me for once. Roll tape. Billy just has does this thing when he'll like go.
I can operate. You guys do it all.
It's like an icon. This is a little. It's like a little nod. This is 10 years of working with him. Show me a sign. It's just this little sign. When he gives that, that's when I know he's totally in character. It's like the Clint Eastwood of infomercials. Quiet on set, please. And big smile, Billy. Action.
Are you one of the 46 uninsured Americans, or
46 million? That'd be nice if it was only 46 uninsured. I don't think we'd be here today.
Action.
If you're one of the 46 uninsured Americans, or if you're one of the millions paying way too much for your current health insurance,
it's 46 million.
46.
If you're one of the 46 million uninsured Americans, call ICANN right now. We could help.
That's it.
This is a lot of copy, a lot of important information. So it's a lot of emphasis on verbiage and how I deliver it, because this is, you know, from the heart, and I really mean it. And it's got to come across that way. And so I'm counting on Sully and everybody to pull me through this.
Service you expect and $5,000 insurance or a health discount plan. No matter what your age.
Here comes the meat and potatoes. I'm going all the way through.
That's a big laundry list.
That's how I do it. I do it like that.
You like that laundry list?
That's how I love that.
And I'm betting you $150 you can't pull this off in one take.
Ooh. That's about a take.
Whoa. Action.
Hi, Billy Mays here for ICANN, a name you can trust. Our plans include doctor visits, hospital stays, surgery, diagnostic testing, x-rays, checkups, emergency room, blood tests, prescriptions, and it doesn't stop there, because nothing is more important than your health.
That's 150.
Ooh. Want to add that
to the tab?
The 12.5 that you owe me?
The 12.5? Oh. I don't owe you 12.5. I owe you half of 5, I know that.
We'll have to take a
calculator. Put it on your tab. That was good.
All right, repo cameras. All right.
Coming up, the whole family gets in the act.
There we go. Let's do it.
And later, will Tom Otosko's awesome auger continue its winning streak? Billy and Sully are shooting a commercial for ICANN, a company that provides affordable healthcare insurance. Billy is so confident about ICANN that he's enlisted the help of his wife, daughter, and his son, Billy III, to help pitch it.
So I've been working about 3/4 of a day now, painting a set and all that, and now all of a sudden my dad's like, hey, by the way, you're gonna be in the commercial. So they sent me up here to get
groomed.
Pretty.
Groomed.
Groomed. I got caught up to the big leagues. I'm suddenly talent. I'm gonna be in the commercial, I guess.
Your makeup looks good on you, dude. You look younger.
No, peekaboo, look at the camera there.
Look at that. You want to see the picture of you?
Okay, Billy, proud father and loving husband. Reading your obituary. Here we go. Ready, Dan? Action.
I'm so passionate about ICANN that I use and trust their benefits for me and my entire family.
You pay your family?
Action.
I trust ICANN for my family's health, and so should you. So call ICANN right now and tell them Billy sent you. One more. Here we go. Last one.
Action.
I trust ICANN for my family's health, and so should you. So call ICANN right now and tell them Billy sent you.
It doesn't get any better. Move on. That's a wrap. Move on.
Nice job.
Billy definitely pulled out all the stops today. And watching him work today and watching him involved in the pre-production for this, it's something he's really passionate about. He really does like the product. And his performance really showed that.
Say hi.
Hi.
Hi, Billy Mays back again with the awesome auger. Just attach it.
4 weeks later, the new awesome auger commercial hits the air. Billy and Sully decide to simultaneously air the original auger commercial with the new one. By checking the call volume on both, the guys will know if the new spot outsells the old.
It takes the hard work out of yard work.
Awesome auger inventor Tom Otosko may have had his life permanently changed by a tragic accident, but he hasn't let it stop him from living life to the fullest.
I now can see that I can focus on my ability, not my disability. So now I'm able to make a living. I'm not going to be a burden on my family. I'm going to be self-sufficient. I'm going to survive. You know, as long as I'm going to be here, I'm not going to be a burden on anybody.
Tom has several more inventions on deck and hopes the awesome auger continues to do well so he can develop his next big idea.
You have obstacles, you know, and they're financial obstacles, they're physical obstacles, whatever they are, you can overcome them. You know, I think I'm proof of that.
Billy now has results for Tom on how the new awesome auger spot is doing.
Got some preliminary points for the auger. It's right on track. It's unbelievable.
The new chute did wonderful then.
It's actually going a lot better than the other one. We tested them both at the same time, and it's outperforming a considerable amount.
We'll just keep this train rolling ahead.
All right, buddy. Glad to hear it.
I'll keep you posted.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, Tommy, I'll talk to you soon.
All right, thanks for everything, Billy. Good night.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye. Great news. We're on a roll.
If the new awesome auger campaign performs as well as the first, it will generate over $10 million in revenue for Tom.
The best part is it now gives me some resources to invent some other products, to get them out to market. We've had ideas for new stuff, but we just need the money now to go ahead and manufacture it and test that it shows before we put them on television. Just a few years ago, I was laying on my back in a hospital bed, and today I'm watching my invention on television. You have a dream, follow it. And I was lucky to be able to follow my dream. So I thank God every day for that. I've got a wonderful wife, I've got a wonderful family, and wonderful friends. So I'm not going to say I'm the luckiest guy in the world, but I feel I'm pretty lucky.